Hi, this is Mark Barner from macgeni.dk. I'm going to go through how to export your delicious bookmarks. I searched the web for it, didn't find any great solutions, only really advanced ones, which is fine. But I was just looking into the delicious site because usually back a couple of months back, it wasn't possible to export your bookmarks from delicious. And delicious is a great bookmarking site if you are looking for something new. But I'm actually changed into using raindrop.io. So what I wanted to do was export from delicious into raindrop.io. So I can use that instead because I think delicious is a little bit behind on the design and the usability. But anyways, they put the feature of export your bookmarks back into delicious, which is awesome, and thank you for that, because that will save us people a lot of time when we want to import or export. So they actually do have this on their website now, under your profile settings and export. You can export a file here. It's gonna end up being an HTML file, and you can look into that file. It's actually pretty neat. You have all your bookmarks now. You can import it into Firefox or whatever. I did want to import it into raindrop.io, so I went to the settings of raindrop.io, and under here there's something called import bookmarks. This is in Danish. I chose other HTML file, and I chose this, and I clicked opened. Open. After a couple of minutes, everything was imported, and if I go back to the overview, you can see it even brought all my tags. So yeah, it really did work, and that's why I wanted to create this guide, because I saw a lot of people created guides to web scraper, and there's actually a script on this site, Ringo. And he created a snippet of code where you can actually export your bookmarks through this into a CSV file. And with this guide, you can export it into the right format. So, but you don't need all that now. It's pretty straightforward with this one here. I hope it was any help to you. I had to spend a couple of hours, even in January, and then again today, just to find out if anything changed. And I'm glad to say that Delicious came back with the export function. And if you liked the video, please click subscribe on our YouTube channel, or you can even contact us through the website here on macgeni.dk, which is a Danish website, but we do a lot of support in English as well. So if you're ever in a situation where you need remote support or anything, you can contact us. Or if you need me to go in through anything interesting that's not working for you, I'll definitely look into that. Please comment on this video if you have any issues with something similar or another Mac or iPhone. I do like to solve people's problems. So thank you for watching. See you again in the next video.